पूरा जा सकते
माननीय मुख्यमंत्री श्री देवेंद्र फडणवीस जी, श्री आशीष शेलार जी, डिस्टिंग्विश्ड कॉन्सुल जनरल्स, एमिनेंट सिटीजन्स एंड एक्टिविस्ट ऑफ मुंबई हु हैव बीन फाइटिंग फॉर द कॉज ऑफ पब्लिक एंड ओपन स्पेसेस फॉर डेकेड्स विद ग्रेट करेज, ऑफन फेसिंग एनॉर्मस प्रॉब्लम्स, इवन थ्रेट्स एंड वायलेंस. हैट्स ऑफ टू यू. Senior government and municipal officers, ladies and gentlemen, it's a matter of great honor for the Observer Research Foundation that our report on this important subject is being released by the Honorable Chief Minister today. Dhanyawad Shri Devendra Ji. This is in fact, as my colleague Dhawal Desai said, the third occasion when the Honorable Chief Minister is participating in and endorsing an activity of ORF Mumbai. Last year, you released our report on drought in Marathwada, which was prepared by our colleagues Nilesh Bani and Swarup Pandit at the Maharashtra Adhyayan Kendra. In September 2015, you blessed our India-China Holy Water Diplomacy Initiative. We at ORF Mumbai, with the support of the Chinese Consulate, had taken a delegation of eminent persons from Maharashtra on a pilgrimage to Kailash Mansarovar in Tibet Autonomous Region in China. The delegation was headed by none other than your gracious wife, Amrita Fadnavis ji. We brought the holy water from Lake Mansarovar, and it was you who immersed the Pavitra Jal from Mansarovar into the Pavitra Jal of Godavari at the Kumbh in Nashik. You described it as Pavitra Jal Sangam between two great ancient civilizations. Maniya Mukhyamantri ji, the report that you have released today is the outcome of extensive research done by my young colleagues, Gautam Kirtane, Saili Mankikar, and Dweep Raj. They deserve a big round of applause. They deserve our appreciation because they have articulated a concern which rarely gets discussed, much less implemented upon in government circles. This report is an urgent cry for help. When a person's life is in danger, he or she cries out for assistance. Similarly, you will hear, Mukhyamantri ji, a loud cry for help from Mumbai's endangered public and open spaces. You will hear an SOS from every page in this report. Why is the issue of public and open space in Mumbai, indeed in every single town and city in today's rapidly urbanizing India, important? Why does it need the attention of the Chief Minister himself? Because, unfortunately, there is a widespread misconception among politicians and government officials that public and open spaces is an esoteric concern voiced by some elitist activists. They think public and open spaces are a luxury and therefore not a felt need of the poor and the common people. Garibana dokyavar ek chhat milala tar bas na. Bag, bagicha, maidan, mokli jaga yanchi garaj ka ahe. Asa anek rajyakartyana vatto. Parantu apan he lakshat ghetla pahije ki garibana samanya manasanna ghar pan pahije ani sundar स्वस्थ परिसर पण पाहिजे. वी डू नॉट नीड रिसर्च टू शो दॅट द लिवेबिलिटी इंडेक्स, द क्वालिटी ऑफ लाईफ इंडेक्स ऑफ अ सिटी ऑर अ टाऊन अँड इवन अ नेबरहूड विद इन अ सिटी ऑर अ टाऊन गोज अप सिग्निफिकंटली वेन रेसिडेंट्स हॅव ॲक्सेस टू पार्क्स, गार्डन्स, मैदान्स वे दे कॅन गो टू रिलॅक्स, वे चिल्ड्रन अँड ॲडल्ट्स कॅन प्ले, वे पीपल कॅन डू योगा, वेअर senior citizens can go for a walk, where there can be cultural activities, music concerts, and so on. Access to public and open spaces is also crucial for the health of the people. For example, I'm a diabetic. My doctor tells me to go for a walk every morning and evening. But where do I go? There is no place for walk or jog near my building. And there are tens of lakhs of people who are far less
fortunate than me. There is another reason why access to adequate public and open spaces is a basic right of the poor and the common people. In my foreword to the report, I have said, I quote, "In a city of mostly nano-sized houses, public and open spaces are the common living rooms for communities. Public and open spaces are the common living rooms for communities, for common people." It's not my thought, but that of Jan Gehl, one of the greatest urban architects in the world from Denmark. Jan Gehl yancha Cities for People या पुस्तकाचा मराठी अनुवाद सुलक्षणा महाजन यांनी केला आहे. ORF ने या मराठी पुस्तकाच्या प्रकाशनाला मदत केली. या पुस्तकाचं मराठी शीर्षक आहे असावी शहरे आपुली छान. या पुस्तकाची प्रत तुमच्या नगर विकास खात्याच्या प्रत्येक वरिष्ठ अधिकाऱ्यांना आम्ही देऊ इच्छितो. My point is this: rich people have richly designed drawing halls and common living rooms with rich furniture. Don't common people need something of their own to call their common rooms, where they can meet, intermingle, socialize? Mukhyamantri ji, aaj Bombay mein aadhe se zyada logon ke paas ek BHK ghar bhi nahi hai. BHK mein H yani hall wo gayab hai. Unke liye to public aur open spaces hi drawing room ho sakte hain. Is it not then the responsibility of the government, of municipal corporations, of urban planners to ensure that they have access to some nice open spaces in their immediate vicinity? To put it bluntly, lack of access to public open spaces has made our city and most of the cities in Maharashtra and India deeply undemocratic and iniquitous. This must end if we care for democracy, if we care for equity, if we care for equality. Let it not be said that the British cared more for Mumbai by creating beautiful maidans and parks such as Oval Maidan, Azad Maidan, Shivaji Park, and so on, and that very few such places have been created after independence in places like Thane, Kalyan, Dombivli, Vasai Virar, where a majority of Mumbaikars now live. Honorable Chief Minister, our report does not only describe and analyze the problem, it also provides very specific recommendations. We would regard this function, for which you have taken out your precious time to come, we would regard this function to be successful only if you instruct the officials concerned in Mantralaya and all the municipal corporations in metropolitan Mumbai to study our report seriously, and also other such reports prepared by activists and organizations, and announce a comprehensive public policy, comprehensive policy for public open spaces for Mumbai, for metropolitan Mumbai, and indeed for all the towns and cities in Maharashtra. I have 5 other important suggestions to make on this occasion. 1, Maharashtra needs a policy for nature parks. America, friends, became a great nation, not only because of its magnificent universities, but also because of its magnificent nature parks. John Muir, who is regarded as the father of America's national parks, says, I quote, and I have quoted it in my foreword to the report, "Everybody needs beauty as well as bread. Everybody needs beauty as well as bread. Places to play in and pray in, where Mother Nature may heal and cheer and give strength to body and soul alike," unquote. Today, sadly, we in India have privatized beauty. I say it again, we in India have privatized beauty and taken it out of public spaces. Beautiful places have become the private monopoly of rich people, and beauty has disappeared from public places. Every citizen should have daily contact with Mother Nature. Therefore, my second suggestion is that we urge you to instruct every municipal corporation to establish an Urban Arts and Aesthetics Commission. Urban Arts and Aesthetics Commission. There is an Urban Arts Commission in Delhi, because of which great transformation has taken place in Delhi over the past 2-3 decades. Nothing like that exists in Mumbai. It's the mandate of this commission should be to bring art and beauty into public places. Our roads, road dividers, footpaths, streets, bridges, footover bridges, above all government buildings. Government buildings, all these must sparkle with beautiful designs. Let us make Mumbai and Maharashtra design rich. Design rich. For this to happen, government should empower the best of our architects and urban designers. Give them ambitious world-class projects in public places. They will derive far greater satisfaction doing design for public good than designing bathrooms and bedrooms for the rich clients. Third, in the case of Mumbai, transform the 400-acre open space at Racecourse into a beautiful nature park on the lines of the Central Park in New York. Why should Racecourse, whose lease has ended, continue to be a privately controlled, privately used open space? Four, we at ORF have prepared 2 detailed reports, as my colleague told you, on cleaning up the Meeting River and transforming Maharashtra Nature Park at Mahim. Impressed by our work, MMRDA invited us to be a knowledge partner for a comprehensive makeover of Maharashtra Nature Park and building an iconic pedestrian-only bridge linking MNP, Maharashtra Nature Park, and Bandra Kula Complex. We conducted a global design competition for this project. It was conducted by my young colleague, Gautam Kirtane. An eminent jury has selected the winning design. As chairman of MMRDA, the chief minister is the chairman of MMRDA, we urge you to take up this project for implementation at the earliest. This will be an eco-friendly new landmark for Mumbai, and history will remember you for giving this precious gift to the city. 5. Mukhyamantri ji, I'm going to make a suggestion which is very relevant in the context of Honorable Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi's New India Vision by 2022, when India celebrates the 75th anniversary of independence. We at ORF Mumbai prepared a report which was mentioned by Dhawal, India at 70. As you know, 2017 marks the 70th anniversary of India's independence. 3 years ago, we prepared a comprehensive report urging the government to beautify, to transform, to maintain all the places in Mumbai that are associated with Mumbai's glorious contribution to India's freedom struggle. We especially focused on 2 maidans, Azad Maidan, August Kranti Maidan. Later, we also highlighted the pitiable state of Sardar Grah, the place that is sanctified by the memory of Lokmanya Tilak. I would urge you, Chief Minister Ji, you please come and see that place. Is it befitting the memory of Lokmanya Tilak? This report was released by none other than the governor of Maharashtra, and yet nothing has happened. Look at Azad Maidan. The Maidan got its name because of its association with 1857, First War of Independence. And what do we see there? Across Azad Maidan is a beautiful architectural jewel, the BMC headquarters. Next to that is CST, railway station, a UNESCO World Heritage Site. And what do we see at Azad Maidan? Right opposite BMC, the entire road, there is illegal encroachment. It has become a slum. How can this be tolerated? This is daylight destruction of heritage. Far from caring for old heritage, far from caring for creating new heritage, We are destroying what we already have. I urge you, ये चलता है attitude बंद होना चाहिए. हमारे प्रधानमंत्री जी अपने अगस्त 15 के भाषण में कहा, चलता है नहीं चलेगा. बंबई में, मुंबई में ये चलता है नहीं चलना चाहिए. I urge you to announce a policy to ensure that every important place, not only in Mumbai, but in all of Maharashtra that is associated with freedom movement, should be developed in a befitting manner well before 2022, that is, India at 75. My last appeal to you, Mukhyamantri ji, please encourage think tanks and take them seriously. Ours is a small think tank. As my colleague Dhawal Desai demonstrated in his presentation, we have done our bit for Mumbai. Of course, we do a lot of work for other areas, but there are thousands of experts in Mumbai in various domains. Set up a think tank in every university, as is the case in many developed countries. Set up a think tank in every university, every district. Seek ideas, suggestions, and expert opinions from intellectuals and experts. Mumbai and Maharashtra, let's admit, Mumbai and Maharashtra have been de-intellectualized. To use an apt phrase coined by the late Arun Tikekar, de-intellectualized. Please end the systemic indifference, yes, systemic indifference, to people's participation and participation of intellectuals and experts outside the government. The time has come to re-intellectualize Mumbai and Maharashtra for holistic, people-centric development. For new India, we have to start with new Maharashtra and new Mumbai. Prabuddha Bharat, Prabuddha Maharashtra, Prabuddha Mumbai, this should be our vision, this should be our commitment. I assure you that the people of Mumbai, the people of Maharashtra, indeed the people of India, will support a leader like you by taking this visionary path. Thank you very much. Jai Maharashtra, Jai Hind, Jai Jagat.